In this webcast, we're going to be discussing recognizing resonance contributors. And the first criterion that we're going to look at in this webcast is going to be planarity. Now, planarity is important because the spatial arrangement of the orbitals that are involved need to have good overlap in order for resonance to occur. We can attempt to explain this phenomenon by looking at this example we see here. This molecule on the left is 10,000 times less basic than the molecule on the right. Now, why is this exactly? One thing we can look at, so to look at the difference between these two molecules, is these methyl groups here on the nitrogen. That's the difference. Now, we're going to look at this molecule on the left first. I first want to identify, we're talking about basicity, the most basic atom in our molecule. Our HOMO, the highest occupied molecular orbital, is going to be that lone pair on the nitrogen. That is going to be the most basic atom in this molecule. And if we wanted to look at an orbital, a three-dimensional orbital picture of this molecule, it is shown here on the right. And we see this lone pair on the nitrogen having a good spatial overlap in a pi-type fashion with the p orbitals of the benzene ring and of the p orbitals on the nitro group, the nitrogen and the two oxygens. And we can see that we have good overlap. We can form this pi bond connecting throughout this entire system. Therefore, that nitrogen is going to be donating into that benzene ring and into that nitro group. Now, if we wanted to draw the actual resonance structure, we can do so as well. So I'm drawing my resonance structure here. Start on our lone pair on the nitrogen. Donates into the ring, and we localize those electrons onto our oxygen. Now, this resonance contributor that we draw here in the middle shows that this most basic atom, this nitrogen, has a significant positive charge associated with it. Now, this significant positive charge comes from the fact that we can donate this lone pair into this pi system. But this is our most basic atom, and if our basic atom has a positive charge, it doesn't make it very basic at all. Now, we can compare this with the molecule on the right, one with our two methyl groups on the nitrogen. Now, there's a significant steric interaction between those two methyl groups and those nitro groups ortho to it on that benzene ring. Now, this significant steric interaction is going to cause these methyl groups to twist. We're going to spin around that carbon-nitrogen single bond there, and we're going to rotate that around in space to lessen the effect of those methyl groups bumping into those nitro groups. So if you look at the three-dimensional orbital picture of this molecule down here on the bottom, we see we have this methyl group above the plane, no longer in the plane of the rest of the p orbitals there. It's now coming out of the plane. And this other methyl group is going down into the plane, which in turn is making this lone pair down the nitrogen, which was in having good overlap with our p orbitals in the top case, is now twisted 90 degrees out of plane here. So therefore, there is not good overlap with the p orbitals anymore. This is very similar to what we saw on sheet one, with our PY orbital trying to interact with our PZ orbital. They're 90 degrees apart. They are orthogonal to one another. There's no good symmetry overlap. Therefore, there's no interaction. So based on what we learned from sheet one, there's no interaction between this lone pair and the nitrogen and the rest of this system here. No interaction. Now, because there's no interaction, we can't delocalize that lone pair into the rest of the system. So that lone pair is no longer tied up in this delocalized bonding. It's not going to have a significant positive charge associated with it, so that lone pair is localized entirely on that nitrogen. Because it's entirely on that nitrogen, it makes that nitrogen a much better base than in our previous example, where the lone pair was tied up. So this is a good example of why planarity is important. The planarity, to show our resonance structures here, had a very significant difference in the reactivity of these two molecules.